This short film is about two friends who stay in touch by email. This is Gloria Caswin.
Can you take me to the computer?
This is Christina Adams. Both Gloria and Christina have multiple sclerosis that has advanced to the point where they no longer have the use of their hands. They can, however, access an ordinary computer by way of a low-cost camera that tracks a small reflective dot on their foreheads. Gloria and Christina use a piece of software called Sue Center. It is named in the memory of the first user, Sue Simpson, shown here with her grandchildren. Note that since Christina is legally blind, she has the letters configured to be larger and in vibrant, contrasting colors, so she can see them better.
Ooh, you got mail.
Show down more. Dear Christina, it's a beautiful day. I have no appointments on Friday, so should we have lunch together?
So, communication has happened. Let's take a closer look at Sue Center and see how Gloria was able to compose her letter. One moves the cursor across the screen. Letters are not chosen until you pause over the one you want. It is not necessary to click the mouse at all. Just pause. Once a letter is chosen, it goes at the end of the message area above. The length of time you need to pause to select can be controlled by choosing faster or slower. You can delete letters and words and can clear the entire message area. On entering P and then E, note that the screen area fills with words that begin with PE. If you see the word that you want, you can choose it from there. Common short words are in the red area. There is also word prediction. Sue Center learns your pattern of word choices. It uses this pattern to predict what you might want to say next.
So how did you spend your time before you got this software?
Well, I watched way too much TV and got bored of that. Sometimes I listened to books on tape. And I spent a lot of time feeling sorry for myself and ruminating and my problems.
Before I wasn't able to do much, I drive my wheelchair with my chin, and there's not a lot of things you can do with your chin. Watch TV a lot, watch flowers grow, and watch paint chip off the wall.
I use the email a lot. I get to email my family that's spread out between Southern California and Texas. And that keeps me in touch. And it makes me feel not so isolated. So I like that. I also have access to the Bible. I have a prayer list that reminds me who I'm praying for. And I love to receive pictures and put them in my photo album. And I also use it to just write about my thoughts and feelings.
Now that I've gotten Sioux Center, I'm really able to do a lot more. Get my horoscopes, play games, journaling, collected pictures. There's so much that now I'm able to do. My dad's over in Thailand, and I email him twice a week. My grandma lives in Merced, and I email her. And they're really happy and excited to hear from me. I wasn't able ever to push buttons on the phone, so now I can talk to them.
My aunt sends me lots of photos, and I can keep them and organize them in photo albums, then recall them and look through. It's like a slideshow.
I'm a mom of an 11-year-old girl, and when we're not getting along, I'll email her something, and then she gets it in the living room, and but it seems to make a difference. Things tend to blow over when she reads it. It's just so empowering to have the ability to make things happen just with a dot on my forehead.
It has enabled me to get back in touch with the world. Not feel so alone. Time goes quickly because I'm so involved with the computer.
So I was journaling a lot, but I really wanted to be able to challenge my brain and be able to do it by myself. So John had come up with this match game that you match colors, and you can make it medium or difficult. It's a really fun little game. Then I wanted more of a challenge, and it gave me one scram, and it's up to 10 letters.
Sun.
Shelter.
Not easy, huh?
No. I mean, you see it now when you
Duh.
It's the blonde.
Yeah.